Disneyland, movies, television, animation, and acquisitions, Disney has gone from Mickey Mouse to Darth Vader, and from theme parks to cruise ships. So put on those mouse ears and let's check out Disney now and then. Walt and Mickey. So where did it all begin? With one talented artist named Walt Disney. From a young age, Walt Disney would draw cartoons for publication and quickly became interested in animation techniques. Of course, these moving pictures didn't look anything like the seamless animation of today. The computer-generated technology of the 21st century has set a whole new standard for animated film. But back then, the ability to create motion from a still picture was truly special. In 1923, Walt Disney turned his talents into his own business venture. Along with his brother Roy, he founded the Disney Brothers Cartoon Studio in Hollywood. Soon after, Disney began working on his most famous creation. In 1928, Mickey Mouse graced the earth with the release of the black-and-white short film Steamboat Willie. This was the first cartoon with synchronized sound and would be but one of many Disney firsts. Since then, the cartoon mouse has taken popular culture by storm. And now, Mickey Mouse stands as one of the most beloved characters of the past century. The most famous mouse on Earth has appeared in over 130 films and became the first cartoon character to get a star on Hollywood's Walk of Fame. With the success of Mickey, it wasn't too long after that Disney introduced Minnie Mouse, Mickey's girlfriend, his dog Pluto, and friends Donald Duck and Goofy, who is also a dog, but unlike Pluto, talks. Yeah, still a little confusing when you think about it. Walt Disney sure hit a home run with this character. It didn't take long before Mickey Mouse became the face of the Disney franchise. Disney, the brand. But the hype around Disney doesn't end with a single mouse. A catalog of movies, television ventures, merchandise, and theme parks has brought Disney to the center stage of entertainment. Snow White, Pinocchio, Fantasia, Bambi, these were the classics of Disney's golden age. These movies and characters paved the way for Disney to branch out beyond animation. In 1955, Disneyland opened in California to great fanfare. The Disney character theme park included rides, attractions, and plenty of Mickey Mouse ears for sale. This was the beginning of the Disney theme park era that would see multiple parks open all around the world. Nowadays, Disney is something of a media mogul. While the studio merged with television network ABC in 1995, the 2000s have been a very busy period for Disney's media expansion, with the acquisition of Pixar, Marvel, and Lucasfilm, among others. This has put some of the biggest movie franchises under the Disney umbrella. Films like Toy Story, Iron Man, and Star Wars are now all part of the Disney universe, along with Mickey and the gang. Never one to miss out on an opportunity, Disney recently launched its own streaming platform, Disney Plus. With new original content and its catalog of past movies and TV shows, Disney Plus is the next phase of the company's media empire expansion. Today, the company's assets are valued at just over $200 billion. Not bad for a company that began with a drawing of a mouse. More than Mickey Mouse ears. Disney Plus has given fans unlimited access to all of their favorite characters. It's no longer just about Mickey and the gang. With the studio's expansion, Disney now lays claim to all the popular heroes of the Marvel and Star Wars franchises. Nowadays, a whole host of spin-off shows have given us new household favorites, like Baby Yoda and Loki. The result? An even bigger gold mine for Walt Disney Studios. But back in its early days, Disney's whole marketing image was focused around its classic creation, Mickey Mouse. We're talking Mickey Mouse t-shirts, ear hats, toys, watches, phones, you name it. Disney Collectibles is now an industry unto itself. Today, every Disney movie release goes hand in hand with the related merchandise. Now, with the rights to Star Wars and Marvel, new characters have brought new merchandising opportunities and even greater profits for the studio. Forget about that Mickey Mouse watch or phone. Some Disney collectibles are worth thousands, with a solid gold Mickey Mouse statue made in celebration of Walt Disney's birthday estimated at over $4 million. The popularity of the Disney brand continues to grow, and there is no shortage of items out there to get started on your own collection. Disney at the movies. So let's take a trip through the movies that have brought these beloved characters to life. As we mentioned before, Steamboat Willie first brought Mickey Mouse to the big screen. The success of the Mickey Mouse shorts gave Walt Disney the boost he needed to produce his first animated feature film. In 1934, Disney decided to tell the story of Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. Before long, over 300 artists and assistants would be working on the project for the next 3 years. Although the film went 400% over budget, the movie was a smash hit when it was released in 1937. By then, the studio had made a name for itself, and Disney quickly realized that its future lay in feature films. Movies like Pinocchio, Fantasia, Dumbo, and Bambi followed soon after in the 1940s. These were technical masterpieces, but costly ventures for Disney. Flash forward to the 1950s, a decade of great success for the studio. After the release of Cinderella, Disney created its first completely live-action film, Treasure Island. This brought huge profits for Disney. Back then, animated films required a lot of work and time to create, which was quite expensive, while live-action films could be made cheaply and more efficiently. Nowadays, the studio has found even greater success in live-action remakes. The potential of computer-generated animation, or CGI, has spurred Disney to create its films with brighter colors and better computer animation. Classics like The Jungle Book, Beauty and the Beast, and The Lion King have been brought back to the big screen in an updated format. Technology has allowed for these remakes to include live-action actors interacting with the familiar animated characters. But there are some movies that will always be remembered more for the original, even if an updated remake has been made. In 1964, Mary Poppins was released with an iconic mix of live action and animation. Today, Mary Poppins is considered one of Disney's finest artistic productions. Everyone remembers that sequence where Julie Andrews and Dick Van Dyke dance in an animated fantasy world. Well, back then, it was so impressive that the film won an Academy Award for Special Visual Effects. 135 Academy Awards later, and the Disney Company continues to pave new ground when it comes to movie making. Disney on TV. It's not only film where Disney has seen great success, the company has also been very prolific on television. Everyone knows the Disney Channel, which was launched in 1983, a network that airs its own TV shows and original movies. Well, way before having its own network, the Mickey Mouse Club aired in 1955, featuring a cast of Mouseketeers. It quickly became television's most popular children's series and made stars of the actors. One of the original stars of the hit series, Annette Funicello, went on to a successful film career after the show ended in 1959. Of course, audiences today would be much more familiar with the likes of Ryan Gosling, Britney Spears, Justin Timberlake, and Christina Aguilera. That's right, these celebrities all started out on Disney's revamp of the classic series in the 90s. While the Mickey Mouse Club had various incarnations over the decades, in the 70s and 80s, Sunday nights were reserved for the Wonderful World of Disney. Each week, the show would serve up a mix of original movies, cartoons, and past Disney classics. Nowadays, Disney Channel is a staple of childhood entertainment. Some of the biggest names in pop culture started their careers on Disney Channel shows. Stars like Miley Cyrus, Selena Gomez, and Ariana Grande, among others, got their big breaks on Disney shows. Never one to miss out on the next big thing, the logical next step for Disney was to create their own streaming platform. Disney Plus launched in 2019, and in 2 short years, the streaming service now has almost 120 million subscribers. from Disneyland to Disney Cruises. In the early days of the company, as feature films and TV series brought success to Disney, the studio began to branch out into whole new areas of entertainment. One thing that fascinated Walt Disney were amusement parks. He wanted to bring the Disney fantasy into an attraction designed not only for children, but for the whole family. This was the grand idea behind Disneyland. In 1955, the $17 million theme park opened in Anaheim, California. That works out to about $130 million today, which seems pretty cheap to build an entire theme park. Back then, the park was home to just 18 rides and attractions. Today, over 700 million people have visited Disneyland, with employees greeting almost 20 million visitors a year. Walt said that Disneyland would never be complete as long as there was imagination in the world. And that statement rings true today. The park continues to expand, offering new worlds and attractions to explore. Since its birth, Disneyland has pushed the boundaries of technology and creativity and influenced theme parks all around the world. With the park's success in California, the next step was a move east to Florida with the opening of Walt Disney World in 1971. The resort is made up of 4 theme parks, 2 water parks, 31 themed hotels, and several golf courses. But why just stick to the U.S. of A.? People all over the world love Disney. So in 1992, the magic of Disney graced Europe with the opening of Euro Disney, a resort that would later become Disneyland Paris. Back then, the resort included 1 theme park, several hotels, and the Disney Village. Today, it offers 2 theme parks, 7 hotels, a 27-hole golf course, and Europe's largest corporate events venue. Not to mention, it stands as Europe's number 1 tourist destination. Nowadays, fans around the world can now choose from 6 different Disney parks: California, Paris, Florida, Tokyo, Shanghai, and Hong Kong. But the fun doesn't stop there. In 1998, Disney introduced its very own cruise liner, Disney Magic, which was an instant hit. At first, Disney Magic sailed on 4-night trips to the Bahamas and paved the way for the exciting new concept of family cruising. Today, the Disney Cruise Line operates 4 different cruise ships: Disney Magic, Disney Wonder, the Disney Dream, and the Disney Fantasy. One thing is for sure, there's no end to vacation choices for Disney fans of all ages. The Disney of Tomorrow. Whether we know it or not, we've all probably had some connection to Disney at some point in our lives. And with the media empire taking ownership of studios like Marvel, Lucasfilm, and Pixar, it's hard to find someone who doesn't have at least one Disney movie they treasure. What started out as an animation company making cartoons has become a series of theme parks, movies, TV shows, and even a streaming platform. Movie franchises are expanding with spin-offs on Disney Plus. Disney theme parks are constantly expanding and building bigger and better rides. Animatronics are taking a back seat as Disney attractions are going high-tech and virtual. And as technology takes on new forms, who knows where Disney could take us next? Forget about the Fast Pass. Maybe one day we'll bypass lines altogether by visiting a virtual augmented reality version of Disneyland. While Tomorrowland may be a creation based on Walt Disney's ideas, maybe some answers to Disney's future lie within. Disney's odds and ends. Here are a few fun Disney facts. Disney may be best known for Mickey and the gang, but did you know that Walt Disney has personally won 32 Oscars? This is an impressive record, as next in line is one-time MGM art director Cedric Gibbons with 11. When Disneyland opened in 1955, 90 million people watched the event live on TV. That's the same amount of people who watched the 2021 Super Bowl. Did you know that The Little Mermaid was the last Disney film made using traditional hand-painted animation? Pixar's development of computer animation completely changed the industry. Okay, here's something you wouldn't expect. Disney is the second largest buyer of explosive materials in America, behind only the U.S. military. This is due to their nightly fireworks display. And did you know that Dumbo is the only main character in a Disney movie to never speak a word? Well, a new Mandalorian episode just dropped on Disney+. Can't miss out. Gotta run. Your support matters, so please hit that subscribe button and ring the notification bell. And to indulge your curiosity, tap or click one of our other videos.